they give me a lot of room, which is really nice, you know. And they leave space in the film for me to add another character, which is, you know, it's not always the case when you're working on films, and it is really fun when you can do that. And you know, of course, this film is just filled with the style of music that I absolutely loved growing up and listened to incessantly, and still do. You know, but you know, between Hoyt Curtin and John Barry and Henry Mancini and all of these guys, I mean, they were my heroes growing up, and I loved the movies that they wrote for. So to be able to kind of write a love letter, a musical love letter to them, is great. And to be able to do it again 14 years later is even better. We have a real, yes, we absolutely have a shorthand, and we have an honesty with each other, which I love. Like, there's nothing we cannot say to each other. He'll let me know when something I'm doing isn't working, or I could do the same for him, and it's really a great collaboration. But the most important thing about it is we have so much fun working together. It's really just always a blast, no matter what it is. And I always know that no matter what he's making, I will always say yes to it, because he's just one of my favorite filmmakers. The reaction of an audience reminds you why you're doing it, you know, because it does mean something to them. It means a lot to them. And when you work on something, when you're lucky enough to work on something like The Incredibles, I mean, that means a lot to me. You know, the fact that people embrace it the way they do. So it makes you work even harder on what you're doing.